In this video, I'll show you how to load WAV sound files in C. I'll be using the C standard library, and I'll only be loading 16-bit single-channel files, though it's easy to adapt the code for additional formats. I'm compiling this code with GCC and linking to WinMM for sound playback on Windows. I'm using the code from my WinMM sound tutorial to play the WAV file sound. We need to include standard I/O to read files. I've created this sound structure to hold the sound samples and sample count. In our main program, we call the loadWAV function to load the sound file, passing it the file name and sound structure to use. First, we declare the return value variable, file pointer, and all the data we're going to load from the file. Several of these are unnecessary, but I included them so you can analyze the WAV files you're loading. We open the file with fopen, passing in the file name and read binary mode. If fopen failed, file will be null, in which case we print the error and return false. Next we use fread, giving it the address to put what it reads, the size of each element, the number of elements to read, and the file to read from. The first 4 bytes of a WAV file are the letters RIFF. If they're not, we print the error, set the return value to false, and go to close file, which is at the end of the function and closes the file and returns. Most of the error conditions will mimic this behavior, so I'll skip over it from now on. Next, we read the file size, the letters WAVE and FMT space, which marks the beginning of the format data. The format length is always 16, and format type should always be 1 for PCM. The number of channels should be 1, then we read sample rate, bytes per second, block align, and bits per sample, which should be 16. Next are the letters DATA to mark the data chunk. We read the data size in bytes and allocate enough memory with malloc. Now we can finally read the sound data. Fread always returns the number of bytes read, so we check it's correct, and if not, we free our allocated memory and otherwise handle the error as usual. Lastly, we set our sound structure's sample count to half the data size, since each 16-bit sample is 2 bytes, then close the file and return. On a successful read, we wouldn't have hit any error conditions, and so return value will still be set to true since its declaration. So whenever we call this function, we can just check whether it returns true or false. That's all the loading code. Now to play the sound, I'm just filling the sound chunks we're passing to WinMM with the sound samples instead of generating sine wave samples. I'm using this sound position variable to iterate over the samples, and when they've all been used, I just tell the program to quit. Cheers! That's how to load WAV sound files in C. In my next tutorial, I'll show you how to do precise timing in C on Windows, and after that I'll be starting my tutorial series on creating a full game in C. Cheers!